Good morning students, how are you all? I hope all are good. Today let us learn about the continuation of the previous class. Okay, what is the name of the chapter? Light and shadow. Students, we have already learned about the basics of light. Look around you, you can see everything. Okay, see the book, you can see this book, you can read this book. Why? Because there is light. Okay, light is here, that is why you can able to see the book. Okay students, when it is dark we can't see anything because there is no light. We cannot see anything in the darkness. Udhar light nahi hai. Okay students, in previous class we learned about light, basics of light. First point, light is a form of energy. Light is a form of energy. It can produce energy. Second point, light can travel from one place to another. Students, what is the example? Sun is the main example. Sun is a natural source of light. Students, we are getting sunlight from millions of kilometers away. Bahut dur se sunlight idhar pahunch jata hai. It means light can travel from one place to another. Then you can do something. When you switch on the torch light, you can see the things from great distance. Why? Light can travel from one place to another. Then third point, light travels in a straight line. Light travels in a straight line. Okay students, okay, let's learn more about light and shadow. Students, show your hand. Your hand, see, behind your hand there is a dark patch. Behind your dark patch, parchai. Okay, this dark patch is called a shadow. Isko kya bolta hai? Shadow. Okay students, why do shadows happen? Shadows are made by blocking light. Shadows are made by blocking light because our hand did not light to pass through it. Okay students, this is known as an opaque object. Our hand is an opaque object. See the pencil. This pencil is an opaque object. See the book, notebook. This notebook is an opaque object. Understand students, shadow is there. This notebook does not let light to pass through it. Okay students, that is why shadow formed. Okay, now students, let us learn about the other objects. Similarly, there are two other kinds of objects. Okay, these objects are transparent and translucent. Okay, transparent, let us learn about the transparent objects. See students, it is a clear plastic. It is an example of the transparent object. Okay, some materials such as glass and clear plastic, this is a clear plastic, allow light to pass through them completely. Okay, we can see everything, we can read the book through this plastic. Okay, it is a transparent. Okay, this clear plastic allow light to pass through it completely. Light jaane deta hai. Okay, these type of objects are called a transparent object. Okay, transparent objects do not form shadows. Dekho isme shadow hai? No, there is no shadows. ओके, ट्रांसपेरेंट ऑब्जेक्ट को शैडो नहीं है. ओके स्टूडेंट्स, देन क्लियर प्लास्टिक एंड क्लियर ग्लास ऑल्सो ए एन एग्जाम्पल ऑफ ट्रांसपेरेंट ऑब्जेक्ट. ओके स्टूडेंट्स, देन लेट अस लर्न अबाउट द ट्रांसलूसेंट ऑब्जेक्ट. सी, इट इज एन एग्जाम्पल ऑफ द ट्रांसलूसेंट ऑब्जेक्ट. ओके, दिस टाइप ऑफ ऑब्जेक्ट, सम ऑब्जेक्ट्स अलाउ ओनली सम अमाउंट ऑफ लाइट टू पास थ्रू दम. ओके, दिस टाइप ऑफ सच ऑब्जेक्ट्स आर कॉल्ड translucent. Certain types of plastic and glasses are translucent objects. See, clear color plastic, color glass. Okay, see, we can see the things but it is not clear. Okay students, okay, translucent object form faint shadows. The faint shadow is there. Okay, it is not dark shadow, faint shadow, light shadow. Okay, we cannot see through a translucent object clearly. See, we can see something but it is not clear. Okay students, we can see something but it is not clear because it is an example of the translucent object. Also wax paper, see the wax paper students, it is a wax paper. Okay, it is also an example of the translucent object. Okay, see the glass, see, it is a kind of glass. Okay, example of the translucent object. Okay, we can see the see, we can see these leaves but it is not clear. okay, a flower vase is there, but it is not clear. These type of glass are called translucent object. It is the transparent object. Okay, students, light passes completely, okay, through a transparent object, but light passes partially, means it is not allow the whole light, okay, complete light, only some amount of light, thoda sa light jaane deta hai, okay, to pass through the, so it is an example of the translucent, it has faint shadows. Okay, now students, let us learn about the shadow. Okay, students, see the candle flame, lighted candle. Okay, students, this lighted candle or candle flame is a source of light. It is a source of light. This needed to form a shadow. Okay, what are the things needed to form a shadow? A source of light. Okay, now this lighted candle is a source of light, candle flame. Okay, or then translucent. Sorry, this is an opaque object. Okay, opaque object or translucent object. Okay, translucent object or opaque object. See, it is the opaque object. Okay, students, then a screen or surface behind the object. Okay, a surface is here, screen for shadow. Okay, students, then what are the features of the shadow? Students, a shadow is formed in the opposite direction of the light. See, opposite direction mein aata hai na. See the shadow. The shadow of the book and the candlelight are in opposite direction. Ana, a source of light. Then, okay, this is the thing. Okay, students, opaque object or book. Okay, then where is the shadow? Shadow is in the opposite direction. Mein shadow aa gaya. Understand, students? Then shadow moves according to the source of light or object. See the source of light, it can move here. Then shadow is also. Okay, students, otherwise see object, book. So students, shadow moves according to the source of light or and object. Understand, students? Then see, students, let us learn about the a shadow is formed when an opaque object comes in the path of the light. See, a shadow is formed when an opaque object comes in the path of the light. Aur ek opaque object light ka path mein jab aayega tab shadow ban jata hai. Okay, it stop the light. Okay, it stop the traveling further. Okay, students, the object which forms a shadow is always between the source of light and the shadow. Object hamesha beech mein aa jata hai, shadow ye object ka peeche aa jata hai. Okay, understand, students? See, where is the shadow? Behind the object. Okay, where is the source of light? Opposite, in an opposite direction. Okay, the object which forms a shadow is always between the source of light and the shadow. See the students, see this, see the piece of wood, it is in the middle part. Okay, students, it is in between the source of light and the shadow. Shadow is here and source of light. Understand, students? Okay, see, students, the size of the shadow depends on the distance between the source of light and the object. Okay, students, the size of the shadow depends, size of the shadow, see shadow size, size of the shadow, it is a small size, it is a big size, it, okay, on the distance between the source of light. Ye to dur hai. Understand, students? Each picture shows the shadow formed by placing a pencil. See, each shadow, each picture showing the shadow formed by placing a pencil. This pencil is here. Okay, more distance. Okay, a short distance. Okay, students, distance from the lighted candle. The shadow is longer when the pencil is far away from the source of light. Understand, students? The shadow is longer. Shadow bada hai, lengthy hai, when the pencil is far away from the source of light. Okay, then next, the shadow is short one. Okay, the shadow is shorter or small one when the pencil is closer to the source of light. Jab pass aa jata hai, shadow chota ho jata hai. Understand, students? Understand? Then the position of the source of light from the objects affects the size and location of the shadow. Okay, the position of the source of light, See, natural source of light, sun. Okay, then of an object also depend on the position of the source of light from the object. Position में ये depend करता है. That is why early in the morning or late in the evening. Okay, when the sun is near the horizon, the shadows of the objects are long. See, early in the morning and late in the evening. Okay, students. So it is a longer shadow. Okay. See, shadow is longer. Longer than afternoon shadow. See, it is very small shadow. Okay, students. So early in the morning and late evening, shadow is longer than the afternoon shadow because of the position of the light. Understand, students? Now, where is the source of light? Near the horizon. Okay, students. A door come. A jada door. Sorry. Okay, students. Then source of light far away from the source of light, then shadow is longer. Understand, students? See, the source of light is, so it is the source of light. Okay, it is far away from the object. This house is the object. Shadow is longer. Understand, student? Now see the afternoon. Where is the source of light? Directly overhead. Understand, students? Whereas the afternoon, when the sun is directly overhead, okay, when the source of light closer, okay, to the object. Now see the shadow. It is a small shadow. Small shadow formed. Understand, students? Shadow formation at different times of the day. Early in the morning, late evening, then noon time. Okay, you can observe it. Students, you can do this experiment. Okay, switch on the light and try to change the position of the light and observe it. Okay, then you can able to understand. You can use a torch light or candle light, anything you can use. Okay, students, good.